India is one of the fastest growing economies in the world. With this growing economy, by 2030, around 40% of country's population is expected to reside in urban areas. When it comes to urban areas, the National Capital Territory of India, Delhi, has experienced one of the fastest urban expansions in the world. Vast areas of croplands are being turned into streets, buildings, and parking lots, attracting an unprecedented amount of new residents. According to United Nations reports, Delhi will overtake Tokyo as the world's largest city by 2030. But how a city which composed of one district and one tehsil with a population of 7 lakh is presently a city of 11 districts and a population of more than 3 crores? NCT, that is the National Capital Territory of Delhi, covers a geographical area of around 1500 square kilometers, and Yamuna River divides the city into two parts, east and west. Several factors such as independence of the country, being the capital of the nation, an influx of immigrants, and a shift in the economy from a primary to tertiary sector over the years have led to rapid infrastructure development and job creation. Thus, a pattern is formed where job creation leads to population increase, which in turn lead to infrastructure development. But at a district level, a varying pattern in urban growth dynamics can be witnessed in Delhi. Historically speaking, the earliest urban centers in Delhi, namely Old Delhi, Shahdara, and Mehrauli, were built in a highly compact manner because of fortification and protective functions rather than insufficient building space. As the urban community tended to reside in close quarters, higher population density was recorded in these areas. The highly compact urban structure and extreme densification still persists in these centers. On the other hand, the British constructed the Lutyens zone in the New Delhi district in a planned manner, and the current government policies have been effective in controlling any major sprawl in that area. New Delhi, which is actually the national capital of India, lies just south of Delhi, or Old Delhi, hosts India's parliament, ministries, and presidential palace, and an abundance of trees, parks, make this region appear as a darker toned region. The rest of the urban pockets developed with time, some planned, while some unplanned, catering to the demands of infrastructure development as well as population pressures. If we look at the urban growth patterns in Delhi, from 1977 to 1993, all districts except the North District showed a rise in the built-up density. This can be attributed to the repeated flooding, eviction, and demolition drives of unauthorized dwellings in the northern districts. Major flooding due to increased discharge from Tajewala Barrage took place in 1977, 78, and 88, submerging most of the low-lying areas and villages in northern district. But slowly, from 1993 to 2006, northern Delhi showed a fairly high increase in built-up area as the construction of right marginal embankment and its extension along the Wazirabad-Pala stretch reduced the flood problem. And afterward, the town of Burari was developed. From 2006 to 2014, there was a considerable increase in urban density in the southwest districts, which can be attributed to the construction of sub-city Dwarka and various other small settlements. Most of the urban growth has been the consequence of conversion of agricultural land into new residential layouts like Dwarka, Rohini, and Janakpuri. Good thing is, only marginal changes are noticed in scrub areas because these regions belong to Delhi Ridge. Delhi Ridge is a northern extension of the ancient Aravalli Range, which is restricted and preserved by the government authority and forest department. The conurbation of Delhi now links the surrounding cities of Ghaziabad, Greater Noida, Faridabad, and Gurugram, which are developing as financial and industrial hubs, due to which these cities are now witnessing a large extent of migration from all parts of the country. Smaller cities surrounding the urban region include Panipat, Rohtak, Rewari, Mathura, Meerut, and Aligarh on the east side. The cities are in turn surrounded by hundreds of small towns and villages, which show up as a small grey dots scattered across the view. But as a result of this rapid and unplanned growth of Delhi over the years, the region is already facing many problems associated with housing, waste disposal, air pollution, traffic congestion, shortage of electric power, and security. Here comes the importance of urban planning. Urban planning is essential because over the time, cities become overpopulated and resources deplete at alarming level. Delhi is a live example. In Delhi, the level of pollution, that is air, water, and land, has increased due to poor urban planning and environmental management. This has its direct impact on quality of urban environment, affecting efficiency of the people and their productivity in the overall development.